NASA is planning on sending astronauts back to the moon that will lead the next generation onto Mars.
To accomplish that, there needs to be new solutions to new problems.
We're gonna focus on isolation.
I like how cozy our design is.
Funding for SciGirls is made possible by NASA. NASA inspires the future generation of space explorers and scientists to engage in the science, technology, engineering, and math that is the foundation of NASA's mission success. Additional funding is provided by PPG Foundation aims to bring color and brightness to communities around the world.
There's a place I go for inspiration. Gotta get to the web, check the girls' investigation. What girl?
And this is where I live. This is my room. I love animals, reading, cooking, and spending time with my family. And my very favorite hobbies are soccer, exploring, and building things. My parents and I hope I'll become a scientist or engineer one day. And look at this. More girls who like the same stuff I do. Science and engineering is for you. Come on, I know you can do it.
Gotta put my mask on.
I'm so excited to explore the Bell Museum.
Today's the day.
We're at the Bell Museum to learn about our project and what we're trying to figure out.
That made me flinch.
My name is Nikki. I'm from India, and I like to read a lot. And my favorite subject in STEM is probably biology and science.
Oh, wow. My name is Lily. I'm an outdoor active person. I'm interested by like chemistry and also space and stuff, like there's other life out there too.
Start dancing. Bow.
My name is Amaya. I like to be creative. I like to go with the flow, and I like botany with like plants and stuff.
Jump. Great job.
There we go. I haven't worked with this team before, so it's all very brand new.
I met Nikki before, but we haven't worked together.
I have no idea what the project is yet, but I'm excited to find out what it is.
Hi, ladies, how are you?
Good.
My name is Nadia. I'm a NASA Solar System Ambassador.
A Solar System Ambassador educates kids on space travels and experiments.
You guys come from different backgrounds, and you guys have never worked together. So this is a really good example of just how NASA is reaching out to bring different perspectives into challenges.
Having a wide variety of perspectives in the team is very important because it contributes new ideas to a solution.
In the next decade, NASA is planning on sending astronauts and humans back to the moon, but also eventually that will lead the next generation onto Mars.
Going from the moon to Mars is a big deal because it's very far away.
And to accomplish that, there needs to be new solutions to new problems.
So your mission is to basically investigate long-term space exploration and the hazards that come with that. We'll get you started. You'll speak with Sally and we'll catch up later.
Awesome.
Yep. Cool.
Nadia suggested that we would meet with Sally and learn about the different hazards of spaceflight and going to Mars.
Oh, wow.
It's so big.
Wow. Hi, welcome to the planetarium. It's so good to have you. I'm Sally.
Sally is an educator at the Bell Museum.
Today you're going to see a preview of a new show that the Bell Museum is producing. It's called Mars, The Ultimate Voyage.
Sally is creating a planetarium film about the space hazards on going to Mars.
All right, so let's go have a seat.
The difference between a planetarium film and a regular film is that the planetarium film shows you different perspectives and like views.
The screen isn't flat, so it's like a dome, and it feels almost like 3D.
It's like immersing you in the travel to Mars and all the different problems that arise while going there.
So these are the challenges you want to be paying attention to.
There's an acronym for the space hazards, and it's called RIDGE. The R stands for radiation, the I is for isolation, D is for distance, the G stands for the lack of gravity in space, E is for hostile environment.
Gosh.
Oh, dang.
The film was really cool, and it made me feel like I was moving with the film.
I got like a little bit nauseous when I was seeing all the stars move.
It made me want to find out more about the different hazards of space that they went over.
Do any of those sound familiar? Like something that's not just happening in space, but might happen down here on Earth?
Yeah, like the isolation during COVID, like you couldn't go anywhere and see anyone, but it's similar, but it's still different.
So yeah, some of the challenges aren't really just for astronauts out in space, but they're important ones to solve sometimes for people here on Earth. In a couple weeks, we're gonna have a screening of this planetarium show. And for that, you're gonna work on one of these challenges that you think you might have some solutions to.
We're gonna focus on isolation and coming up with solutions.
It relates a lot to what we've been through for the past 2 years in the COVID-19 pandemic, where we were all in isolation.
We are going to present our project at a screening of the planetarium at the museum.
1, 2, 3, Mars!
Hello, I'm Nikki, and I'm gonna show you what I like to do.
I play volleyball.
Here, I'm gonna show you how I surf.
So today for lunch, I made puri, which is like fried bread, and I made a mixed vegetable curry.
Here it is. This is really good. I'd probably rate it 8 out of 10.
I like to play violin. This is the D major scale. Thanks for listening.
Today we were at Nikki's house to brainstorm a little bit about like what we know about social isolation.
What are some like problems that you guys have like had with like isolation?
The lack of change, like everything's the exact same like every day.
Just like being stuck in the same like routine.
I think it would be beneficial to us to go on the internet and see what NASA has done so far about these unknowns.
So we started researching what's known about isolation, and then we also kind of looked into what is unknown about isolation.
So I found this really cool website that NASA uses to put down like analog missions.
And analog is basically like just a test run.
This one site that I found is an analog mission where it focuses on the hazard of isolation called HERA, Human Exploration Research Analog.
Maybe we can talk with one of the HERA researchers and see what they found out about the effects of isolation.
I think that's a great idea.
Yeah. We are meeting Dr. Kim Seaton. She is a psychologist at NASA.
Hi! It's so great to see you.
We've been looking into the HERA missions, so could you tell us a little bit more about that?
Excellent, sure. We have a crew right now. They are on mission day 8 today of 45 days. So they are living and working inside that habitat on Johnson Space Center.
What do you think are some key points that we should focus on?
HERA, the habitat, is very cozy. It's kind of like a studio apartment, one bedroom, one bathroom, very small. And when you think about a spacecraft like that, there's very little privacy. So the HERA crews, they have their individual crew quarters, and it's kind of like a little one-person tent, but there's no privacy. There's no interior walls separating them. And so if someone snores, they're gonna hear it.
really does pose a problem of how four crew members, usually, they don't have any privacy and they're basically all open.
Sleep deprivation, that's a big one. On the ISS, they're orbiting the Earth. So they see sunrises and sunsets about every 40 minutes. So that can be very disruptive to the circadian rhythms.
So while I was doing some research, I came across the fact that some astronauts use journals. Can you explain a little bit more on that?
Oh, that was a great find. Yeah, similar to other explorers throughout history, astronauts, many of them have enjoyed journaling. It's a way to reflect and learn from their experience. And it's also, it gives the researchers a tool to monitor behavior, see their thoughts.
So when can we check back with you?
How about we meet again in a couple of weeks?
That sounds great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, girls. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hi, my name is Lily, and one of my hobbies is playing my guitar.
Another one of my hobbies is soccer.
Hello. Another thing that I like to do is to read books.
Another hobby I like to do is photo editing.
Let's talk about what we learned.
Yeah, we can go over some solutions.
The lack of privacy in the spaceship, since it's so small. I had an idea that you could put curtains up.
Maybe curtains and like noise machines. You know, at rec centers, they have like different rooms dedicated to different things.
What if there's like a little small space, like a mini booth, and you can just go in there and be by yourself? Like maybe there's like some noise canceling headphones in there.
I think also changing the lighting, like having fairy lights.
Yeah.
We're doing something called a wellness booth, which combines the problem of privacy, mental health, and just happiness in general.
When we're using this space, maybe like we can film part of it and just basically like talk about what we're doing and like reflect on it, you know, and then we can come back and share it.
So our next step is we're going to make prototypes out of like cardboard boxes.
You have to do a little bit of math here. Eight feet into thirds.
Yeah. How many inches is 8 feet?
96.
One wall size is 32 inches long.
That looks right. Right, and then the other side.
Yeah, we have to do the same thing. Like that. So it's a confined space just for you.
Good job.
Let's fold.
We're each gonna take one home and do little like video diaries.
And then we can make this one like this.
Our goal is to spend like 15 to 30 minutes in there each day, and we're like gonna customize it to our needs and like what we want in there.
I think that'll help us in the next phase by mimicking what the astronauts would do.
I'm excited to like tell my sister to leave me alone and to like give me some privacy.
Yay!
This was a good one.
Yeah.
Day one of the Amaya mission.
I remember when I was sitting in there, it was really small.
After reading for around 25 minutes, I just felt more relaxed in here.
Today I decorated the booth a little.
It was really fun, like just to be down there and just kind of doing whatever.
Today, I didn't really do much, but I did take a really good 30-minute nap.
Today, I'm going to be doing some homework.
Not much changed, except I went from like a ton of energy to a little energy.
It's feeling really cramped in here. It's kind of like small, but I think we're gonna take a nap in here today.
Now I just played my ukulele, and it was really nice, actually, because I just sort of got to like reset and rewind.
This is my prototype.
Oh, wow. Today we are at Nikki's house and we are going to be discussing our different booths and then combining our ideas into the final prototype.
Did you feel like you had like enough space?
Yeah, you know, I could like stretch out my legs a little bit and sit around comfortably. I think my mood changed after I used the booth. Like I just felt more like calm and relaxed.
So this is what mine looked like. I just wrote on the walls mostly one day.
Oh, I like the idea of like putting quotes down.
Mm-hmm. Or just having like conversations on the wall.
Yeah. I drew, I wrote, I read, I played my ukulele, and I knitted.
So here's my space. Kind of decorated it with some like washi tape.
I sat on the floor with a pillow and then I just kind of filled it with things like books or blankets or stuffed animals.
What was one of the things that didn't really work that well in the booth?
I guess like just kind of like stretching it.
Yeah, but like there wasn't a ton of space.
Yeah. We wanted our size to be more inclusive because the prototypes that we made are just for like us, you know, like 13, 14 year olds.
The cardboard prototype we have, the wall, one wall size is 32 inches long. Should we raise it to 3 or 4 feet?
Maybe like 4 feet, yeah. Not too much longer because there's not a lot of room.
We just sort of like bounced ideas off of each other. And I don't think we had any like big major disagreements. We were just sort of like going with the flow. And I feel like we all worked together.
Maybe wall number two could be like the picture wall.
Mm-hmm. Maybe spaces to write on the wall if you want to. We decided to use a fold down desk and using a virtual window for different like backgrounds depending on what kind of mood you're in.
Since we might have like a desk, we should have a chair.
Yeah.
I think they're great teammates to work with. They're very open-minded.
Working with Lily and Nikki so far has been great. We make a good team and you know, teamwork makes the dream work, so.
It looks great.
Yeah. So now we're ready to start building.
All right, yeah. Let's go.
Suspenseful music. The entire thing's gonna be made out of cardboard, but to keep it together, we're gonna have Velcro and these little screws that we can put in, and then we can take them back out too so we can reassemble it later. It's trying to fold at this like edge right here. The most challenging part, I think, is figuring out how to do it with cardboard.
Cardboard isn't really like wood. Like you can't just like screw it and be done with it. You actually have to think about how you should position it. These little curvy thingies in the middle of the cardboard, that's the corrugated part of it. If it's vertical, it'll be stronger than if it's horizontal, because then it'll fold.
Cardboard can be your worst enemy or your best friend. It's like, it's sturdier than paper, but when you're really trying to like build it and it bends where you didn't want it to bend, that can be very frustrating. But we're figuring out how to make it work. There, it's like a little door. Ta-da!
I think the most fun part is constructing it and then seeing what will happen at the end.
All right.
So now do you guys want to put the roof on?
Yeah.
Sure.
Hey.
Hey.
It's bending.
Yeah.
We're gonna need to figure out after we screw them in how to deal with that.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
It looks like a house.
Yeah.
It is a house.
We did good, you guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
High five.
Try five.
Try five.
Hey guys, it's Amaya. I'm here at the lookout on the High Bridge. I really enjoy walking across the High Bridge in the summer and heading downtown. I'm here with my mom. We're running some weekend errands. I really enjoy spending some time with my mom and hanging out with her. She's like my best friend slash mom.
So my best friend Charlotte, we're both in Girl Scouts. My mom is our Girl Scout leader. I've been in Girl Scouts since I was 5.
One of the traditions of my household is celebrating Galentine's Day. We eat treats and have lots of laughs.
I'm here with my sister.
Hello.
And we're both in Girl Scouts, and we're about to go deliver some cookies.
I'll see you guys later.
Oh, sorry.
It's like bending a lot.
It is.
Today we're working on getting our booth finalized.
And we're also gonna see Nadia, and she's gonna give us some feedback.
So first, we kinda like made the desk part.
It's gonna be like that, wasn't it?
And our plans, we said we were gonna have like these triangles pulled into the wall. And then we made it so that it would fold upward.
All right, how does that look?
Looks good.
How does it feel?
It feels good. I feel like I have enough leg room underneath. It's a little flimsy.
Maybe we should add 3 total, 1 in the middle and then 2 on the sides.
Yeah.
I am very impressed with that. We were able to pull that off.
One this way. Today was kind of like a check-in with Nadia to see how we're doing with our design.
What we created was a wellness booth. So this was the first prototype.
Is that what the smiley faces are for? To make you feel happy? And
yeah, sure.
Okay, I like it.
And in our new prototype.
So do you kind of want to try it out?
Sure, yeah.
We will fix the roof, we promise.
Okay. Yeah. All right, great. So this will definitely accommodate my height.
It was like really nice to like get somebody's new perspective on it.
There's gonna be like a virtual window. Because when you're in space, you only see space.
Right.
So you miss stuff on Earth. So if you wanna like set it to different backgrounds and stuff.
And we were also thinking about getting a diffuser to like stimulate like smells and stuff.
Very cool, that would be nice. So you guys wanna activate the five senses, right?
Yeah.
That's definitely very important for us. Have you guys thought about the situation with gravity? As you know, astronauts are experiencing microgravity. So how will I be able to sit down on this chair, relaxed?
Nadia told us that we should be more aware of how gravity can affect our booth and how we should accommodate for it.
So I love this table, but I did notice that the edges are a bit, you know, rough.
To have Nadia be able to look at our progress that we've made so far, it was nice to see like sort of how far we've come.
Okay, so I know you guys have a few more things to add, and I don't want to throw more things to add, but I think that it would be a great idea to put together a mission patch. The fun thing about NASA is that they put together mission patches for all of their missions, and the even cooler thing is that usually the crew members design their own mission patch.
A NASA mission patch shows that you're part of a NASA mission, and it shows what kind of mission you're on.
So you guys can design that, and your museum visitors will be able to see that in an artistic way.
Yeah.
All right, cool, I'm excited to see it.
There you
go. Break right here.
Yeah, that looks good.
Will the lights work?
A little more now.
Whoa, what
are
they?
We're just seeing how dark it will be.
Ooh. Ah. I like how cozy our design is.
It feels like a home, like a mini home.
Like for the outer circle, maybe it should have like hazards of deep space.
When we were designing our mission patch, we were thinking about what words we wanted to incorporate that sort of summed up what we were trying to do. Should we maybe write wellness?
Mm-hmm. Or like what if we like wrote like wellness everywhere?
Yeah.
Okay guys, here's the design.
Oh, I like it.
I do too.
We'll use our mission patch to show everyone that we're part of this mission when we're presenting our project to everyone.
Today we are working on finalizing the booth.
And also to ask Dr. Seaton for like tips on how to improve.
Okay, Amaya, can you push against it?
Yeah.
Okay.
It looks good.
Okay.
So in our new roof design, first we changed the direction of the corrugation because we noticed that the roof was folding a lot.
Righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Yep. Oh wait, and I was turning it the wrong way. We put some quotes on the wall too, next to the window, which we also finished.
I like this quote where it's, you can do hard things, because that's just empowering. Although there were some problems, like while building it, I never really felt that stress because all of my teammates and me, we were in this together.
They look like stars.
They do,
right here.
Yeah.
Today we are meeting Dr. Kim Seaton to get a little bit more feedback.
Hi.
Hi, it's so great to see you again.
So we're here in our wellness booth.
All right. Well, I'm excited to see what you've been up to. Can you walk me through it?
Here we have a seatbelt. So when you are sitting at the desk, you don't want to be floating around.
Nice. I love that.
It felt really good to share a project with Dr. Seaton because she works with astronauts and she kind of knows what they need.
It felt very rewarding because we spent a lot of time on this.
I am so impressed with what y'all have put together. You're going to inspire people to hopefully take better care of themselves.
Thank you so much for meeting with us.
Yeah, we really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. We'll definitely send you pictures of our presentation.
Best of luck with your presentation at the museum.
Thank you.
Bye.
Does this look good?
Yeah.
Yep. I feel pretty relieved now.
because now I don't have to really do anything, except I just have to present to the guests in the Bell Museum, which now I can look forward to.
I think we're ready.
I think it's gonna be really fun to show people what we've worked on, and I hope they like it.
Come on in. Hello. Hi.
Some of the activities that are a part of today is a special screening of Mars, the Ultimate Voyage, as well as we are getting feedback on our wellness booth.
We're taking some of their feedback on how to cope with isolation and putting them all on our wellness board.
We will have them make their own mission patch, like the ones we have right here.
We were researching about the hazards of deep space.
We were thinking of some solutions and ways to kind of cope with isolation, and that's where the wellness booth idea came in.
It says hazards of spaceflight because that was the problem we were focusing on. And then wellness everywhere is the solution because we want the astronauts to be well. Here are some stickers of our mission patches. Mm-hmm, you're welcome.
I hope that people learn that they can make something as simple as a cardboard contraption to help with space exploration, and that it's not just astronauts working to go to space. It's like so many different types of people can be in NASA. Right behind you, there's a desk that folds down.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Most of the guests today said they really liked it.
They make me feel like relaxed and calm.
It can help people on Earth too with mental health, and we see how the pandemic has affected people as well, which is why I think their project is so valuable.
I think this is awesome. You guys did an amazing job, and I'm proud of you.
The astronauts on a trip to Mars would be lucky to have such great things to help them take a break.
You guys should be so proud of yourselves.
Even though our project was specific, I think it's important to practice wellness wherever you are.
We've only just begun the research, so there's so much more that can be explored and discovered.
Wellness everywhere.
That's super cool.
Maybe when I grow up, I'll probably work for NASA.
We should take a photo to send to Kim Seaton.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yay, team!
Funding for SciGirls is made possible by NASA. NASA inspires the future generation of space explorers and scientists to engage in the science, technology, engineering, and math that is the foundation of NASA's mission success. Additional funding is provided by PPG Foundation aims to bring color and brightness to communities around the world.
Thank you.